Hi, my name is Leonard Roosevelt, and I'm going to present to you our poster, Compressed Sensing for OCTA Volume Generation. For OCTA and Geography, or OCTA for short, image data are commonly computed using formulas such as amplitude decorrelation, speckle variance, or interframe variance. To the best of our knowledge, there is no established standard for denoising of OCTA images. However, edge-preserving filters, such as the median filter, are popular for denoising OCTA volumes and images. Compressed sensing has been successfully used in computed tomography, MRI, and also for spatial OCT, that means non-angiography data. The data used for the evaluation were acquired from the eye of a 28-year-old volunteer at the Newman Eye Center, Boston, using a prototype OCT device developed by our collaborators at MIT in Cambridge, Massachusetts. The volunteer's eye was scanned 10 times to allow the computation of a ground truth OCTA volume, but each B scan in each of these 10 scans was repeatedly scanned 5 times to allow the computation of angiography for each scan. The 10 scans were co-registered using the non-rigid OCT motion correction technology by Plona and Kaus. After registering, the 10 OCTA volumes can be merged into a low-noise ground truth. One of the 10 scans is picked as a test scan for reconstruction. The reconstruction fundamentally works by minimizing the data consistency term in equation 1. X hat is the less noisy OCTA volume that we want to reconstruct, and which minimizes the data consistency term. Y are the structural OCT data that we acquired during a scan. We now try to maximize the probability by finding an OCTA volume X given our structural OCT data Y. L is a likelihood function for speckle variance that has been derived previously by Stefan Plona and others. Equation 2 shows the log likelihood derived from an angiography volume X. The gradient is computed at each voxel position P of the volume. N is the number of scan repeats, 5 in our case, and Y denotes the structural OCT data. Mu is the mean of all Ys at the position P. This gradient allows to minimize the data consistency term. However, if we pick an arbitrary initialization for the OCTA volume X and only minimize the data consistency term, we arrive at the OCTA speckle variance volume that we could have computed immediately in the first place. We still need to add a regularizer. Here we use a median filter as a regularizer with a 3x3x3 filter kernel. Not only is the median filter an edge-preserving filter, it also minimizes the L1 norm of our volume in image domain. The algorithm works as follows. We initialize X0 by computing the speckle variance OCTA volume. We apply the regularizer and perform n reconstruction steps using the gradient and the step size lambda. Then we regularize again and so forth. We can find out whether our reconstruction converged by computing the mean squared error between the initialization and the current reconstruction. If the error does not change anymore, the reconstruction converged. We did not calculate the error between the ground truth and the reconstruction from the volumes, but from unfast projections instead. We segmented the retina pigment epithelium and the inner nerve fiber layer. We projected the retinal space in between using 90th percentile projection to obtain unfast projections of the retinal vasculature. These projections were used for computing the mean squared error. The graph shows the mean squared error between the ground truth and the OCTA initialization. The green lines show the mean squared error between the ground truth and OCTA reconstruction after the initial regularization, that is, after the first application of the median filter. The blue line shows the reconstruction error over the reconstruction iterations. Once the reconstruction converged, we reduced the mean squared error by approximately 11%. The unfast projections show, from left to right, the ground truth, the OCTA initialization, the initialization after the first median filtering step, and finally after 1,002 iterations. If we take a closer look at the detail areas, we can see that the image noise decreased after median filtering and, of course, after performing reconstruction. This is especially visible in the areas between capillaries. We show, to the best of our knowledge, the first application of compressed sensing for the reconstruction and denoising of OCTA data. This is just the first step that shows the compressed sensing reconstruction of OCTA data is feasible, and we intend to look into different, more promising regularizers and more test data in the future. Thank you for watching.